There's a lot to love about Japan's train culture. This time we're in Kyoto. We're going to be riding the beautiful Eizon line, which extends from the center of Kyoto at Daimachi-Yanagi Station out to Kurama Station in the countryside. It's a beautiful ride, and I'm going to be doing it with this day pass, the Kyoto-Osaka Sightseeing Pass from Keihan Railways, and it's kind of a passport to the beautiful countryside. And one of the fun things about the Eizon line are the trains. They're pretty cool.
The Eizon line is a local train line, two tracks in the suburbs, one shared track in the countryside. These local trains are called Wanman Densha, or one-person operated train. They're often seen in the countryside where rider numbers are lower. The conductor or driver does everything during the operation, including collecting tickets and payment. The Eizon line is an Eiden, or electric train, and they have quite an interesting lineup of trains to attract fans who love to ride the rails. There are 8 stations on the original Eizon line, but it splits after Takaragaike to the Kurama line, which has a total of 15 stations. It takes about 40 minutes to ride to the end. Decades ago, these were strictly commuter trains, but now they carry more and more tourists to Kyoto's countryside. It all starts at Daimachi-Yanagi Station. Let's talk with the train conductor to learn more about the Wanman train.
Eizon電車ではワンマン運転という電車の運転の仕方をしております。 まず乗られる時は後ろの入り口ドアから乗っていただいて、降りる時に前のドアから降りていただいて、その時に切符または運賃を支払っていただくというシステムになっています。
When you exit in the front, you pay at the machine by the door. Drop in exact change. If you don't have it, use the bill and coin changer before you get off to make the line go smoothly when departing. When the train is in operation, conductors are focused on controlling the train. Each train has slightly different controls. When the train stops, the driver turns into the conductor. Smaller stations don't have staff to collect tickets. Only the front door will open, so all passengers can touch their IC cards or deposit the ticket or fare. Those with passes need only show the date to the driver. There are constant visual safety checks before the Wanman train departs the station. Wanman Densha drivers are the ultimate multitaskers. The Eizon line also has these new trains running to Kurama Station. There are two. This orange one is the Kirara train. Yes, each one has a name. The windows are large, and some of the seats face the window to better enjoy the country view. It really is a beautiful train to ride.
And this train won an award for being the best train in Japan in 1998.
The Kirara won the Laurel Prize as best train. It's easy to see why. It's fun to ride, and there's a reason why this train changed its design.
Now, it was before 1990, the trains were kind of different. It was a commuter line where people lived out in the countryside and commuted into Kyoto. And It was after 1990 where they started to change the strategy. There were more tourists coming in, and as a result, the trains changed. And now you have so many different kinds of trains on the Azine line. That's what makes the Azine line really unique.
Another train on the Azine line is decorated with all four seasons in an anime-wrapped train. It highlights the wildlife and nature found in Kyoto's countryside. Winter, fall, spring and summer. It's hard to miss when it passes you by. The forest green trains are nostalgic, the look of decades ago, but they're new. Wood paneling and floors are a nice touch. The newest train launched is the Hiei, highlighted by the circular front and windows. It follows the original Azine route, but gives the feeling of luxury on what was once a simple commuter route. You can even buy train merchandise at Daimachi Yanagi Station. Train schedules are always listed in English at the station. At major stations, Japanese staff often direct exiting passengers to keep the flow moving smoothly and safely. Our first stop along the Azine line is also the first station. Daimachi Yanagi Station has a retro shotengai, or covered shopping street, where few tourists come. It's a slice of real Kyoto life. Each mom-and-pop shop focuses on a speciality, like fruits and vegetables, flowers, clothes, bags, books, kimono, tempura, cinema, stationery. The decorations are also pretty interesting too.
Kyoto's history goes back centuries, if not millennium, and it's really interesting to see that this era, the Showa era, is still represented pretty well here in the city.
The area is also known for its confections. By the entrance of the Shotengai is this shop selling Japanese sweets. I ordered one right before the shop closed. Mame mochi. Mochi itself doesn't have a lot of taste, just a chewy consistency.
Okay, I got one. This is called Mame Mochi. It's what this confection shop is really famous for.
And it's rarely eaten alone. See those beans inside? The Azuki red bean paste called Anko is a delicate natural sweetness that complements the mochi well.
Oh, that's interesting. This mochi is red bean paste called Azuki. It's actually surprisingly sweet. The mochi has absolutely no flavor whatsoever. It's the Azuki red bean paste. But the beans inside of it, the whole beans, give it really good consistency. I quite like this. It's only 200 yen or about $2.
Every train line in Japan has a history to it. As we make our way to the next station, let's hear about the Azine line.
Azine 電車はですね、今から94年前、1925年に Azine 本線が開通しました。その時の建物がまだ残ってまして、あちらの三角の屋根の建物が開業当時から残っているものです。その4年後にですね、鞍馬線が開通しまして、去年から今年にかけて90周年を迎えております。
鞍馬 station looks historic too.The green moss growing on the roof, a symbol of the nature all around it.
Kurama-sen にはですね、もみじのトンネルという風景が綺麗なところもあるんですけれども、そういったところライトアップを始めたりとかですね、そういったところで観光のお客様誘致に取り組んできました。
In the summer, the Azine line to Kurama looks like this. But in the fall, when the leaves change, so does the experience on the train known as the Momiji Tunnel. Keihan lights up the maple trees on this stretch of the line.It's been a hit, attracting more riders to make the trip to Kurama and back. The beauty of the train line is enjoyable in all of the four seasons. But last year, the line had its biggest challenge in its 90-year history. A typhoon caused a lot of damage to Kyoto, especially at the end of the Eizan line.
一番大きな出来事は昨年の台風21号でですね、1ヶ月半ほど運転を見合わせなければならないということが起こりました。まあ、その時はですね、そういったことは長い歴史の中で一月半も止まるというのは初めてのことだったかと思うんですけれども、まあ、技術のスタッフだけではなくてですね、本社からも応援に行ったりとかですね、いろんなところを手伝えるところを各部署で担当しながら全員で復旧を目指したというです。
You can still see the damage a year later. Getting the train back operating was a team success for Keihan Railway.And a reason why the line is so beloved. If you are a resident of Japan like me, you can get a day pass for 1,000 yen. But international visitors can buy passes all the way to and from Osaka. This shop inside Kyoto Tower sells it for 1,500 yen for the whole Keihan network. I also found English guides next door, many college students happy to talk about their city. Let's make a brief stop at Ichijoji, known as Kyoto's ramen town.We'll explore this more in the next episode where my friend Shingo and I eat at several ramen shops in the area. Ichijoji is a must-stop spot for any ramen lover. Our next and final stop is the Kurama and Kubuneguchi station, which is loaded with attractions. Not far from Kurama station is Kurama Temple, the starting point of a 3-kilometer hike. The Mount Kurama cable car will take you part of the way, which saves time for the elderly, those who come often for worship. There are nice views from the top.This is also where you can hike around the woods and hills to the Kibuneguchi Station and Kifune Shrine. Kifune Shrine is famous for its stairway up. You can buy omikuji or fortune-telling slips, which need to be soaked to find the real fortune.Tie it here so it'll come true, or not. Many people jump on a local bus to the Eizan line at Kibuneguchi Station. I traveled back to Kurama for one more thing to do. If you keep going past the temple steps, you really see how calm life is in Kyoto Prefecture.This is also where you'll find one of the closest hot springs to the city, Kurama Onsen. Day trippers can come here for a soak for only a few hundred yen. Like all onsen, rinse off before getting in.And let the hot water and tranquil sounds of nature renew your body and mind. You'll leave Kyoto and the Eizan line happier and more relaxed than when you came.